Hello, my beautiful besties, and welcome to another reaction. I got a song for you today called The Hurricane. It's by Bob Dylan, and it was requested for by Bennett Joseph. Let's go get it.
Pistol shots ring out in a barroom night. Enter Betty Valentine from the upper hall. She sees a bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, my God, they killed them all. Here comes the story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but what? Champion of the world. Three bodies lying dead as Patty C, and another man named Bello moving around mysteriously. I didn't do what he says, and he throws up his hands. I was only robbing the register, I hope you understand. I saw him leave and he says, and he stops. One of us had better call up the cops. And so Patty calls the cops, and they arrive on the scene with their red lights flashing in a hot New Jersey night.
I know of this man, the Hurricane. You know, it's a very, very sad story. It always makes me angry when I hear that story. Denzel Washington actually starred in a movie, you know, about this man, and that's how I got to know about the song. Sorry, about the man, his plight, you know. And I didn't read as well then that Dylan was one of the people who like stood up for this man, because I saw, you know, quite a few documentaries, but I never heard the song. And to start with, right, of all the Dylan songs I've ever heard, this is the one that sounds the grooviest. It's almost like it's almost like R&B, you know. It's almost like a party song. And I'm thinking maybe the reason why the music is like that is because it's about a black character, and Dylan wanted to you know, appeal a bit more to the black audience. It might sound somehow to you guys, but that's what I feel, you know, because this song is so groovy. You know, if I heard this instrumental, I would never have thought it was a Dylan instrumental. You know, it's fantastic. I love it. You know, like I said to you, you could play this in a nightclub. It's that groovy, you know. And the story, I'm following the story now. You know, it's sad when you like realize that it's a true story. That always gets to you, you know. And when he said he could have been a world champion, you know, you just think to yourself, look at the way they've like wasted this man's whole life, you know. And the guy got out right. He wasn't even beaten, you know. Let's get some more. I want to hear more of that groove, man. It's a beautiful song. I love it.
Meanwhile, far away in another part of town, Reuben Carter and a couple of friends are driving around. Number one contender for the middleweight crown. Had no idea what kind of shit was about to go down when a cop pulled him over to the side of the road. Just like the time before and the time before that. In Patterson, that's just the way things go. If you're black, you might as well not show up on the street, unless you wanna draw the heat. Alfred Bello had a partner and he had a rap for the cops. Him and other Dexter Bradley were just out prowling around. He said, I saw two men running out who looked like middleweights. Jumped into a white car without upstate plates. And Miss Patty Valentine just nodded her head. Cops said, wait a minute, boy,
Wow. Powerful stuff, guys, man. I swear, this song makes me so angry. It's a beautiful song, the groove, man. I'm just thinking to myself, how I wish this groove was like to another song, because I feel almost guilty trying to enjoy the music, when I know what's behind it. Dylan has done like fantastic here. This is apart from the like a message, it's just a fantastic song, man. I love it. I love the way he tells the story. I love the way he phrases here. I love the groove. I love his humanitarian side, and at that time, for him to speak out, on a subject like this, it was a huge thing. But that's what the man was always like anyway. So to Dylan, it's not a biggie. I just love the song, man. But at the same time, I'm so sad, let's get some more groove.
A prison cell, but one time he's gonna be the champion of the world. Four months later, the ghetto's on flame. Rubens in South America fighting for his name. Well, out the decks, the Bradley's still in the robbery game. And the cops are putting the screws to him, looking for somebody to blame. Remember that murder that you happened in a bar? Remember you said you saw the getaway car? Think you'd like to play ball with the law? Think it might have been that fighter that you saw running that night? Don't forget that you are white. The Bradley said, I'm really not sure. The cop said a poor boy like you can use a break. We got you for the motel job and you're talking to your friend Bello. You don't want to have to go back to jail, be a nice fellow. You'll be doing society a favor. That son of a bitch is brave and getting braver. We want to put his ass in the stir. We want to pin this triple murder. Take a man out with just one punch, but he never did like to talk about it all that much. It's my work, he'd say, I do it for pay. And when it's over, just as soon go on my way. Up to some paradise, where the trout streams flow and the air is nice. And ride a horse along the trail, but then they took him to the jailhouse, where they tried to turn a man. Were marked in advance. The trial was a pig circus. He never had a chance. The judge made Rupert's witnesses drunkards from the slums. To the white folks who watched, he was a revolutionary bum. And to the black folks, he was just a crazy nigger. No one doubted that he pulled the trigger. And though they could not produce the gun, the DA said he was the one who did the deed. And the old Nigeria agreed.
I cannot even imagine in those times how you have an all-white jury, in a country where it's multiracial, and especially when the guy on trial, it's a black guy, for killing a white guy, supposedly, and then you have an all-white jury. I don't. And it was still happening until a few years ago. Just madness, man. Madness, really.
Did the deed, and the old white jury agreed. Carter was falsely tried. The crime was murder one. Guess who testified? Bello and Bradley, and they both all they lied. And the newspapers, they all went along for the ride. How can the life of such a man be in the palm of some fool's hand? To see him obviously framed couldn't help but make me feel ashamed. To live in a land where justice is again. Yeah. ties. I'm free to drink martinis and watch the sunrise, while Ruben sits like Buddha in a 10-foot cell, an innocent man in a living hell. Yes, that's the story of the hurricane, but it won't be over till they clear his name and give him back the time he's done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world.
I'm just so angry after that, you know. Anyway, maybe it's not the right place. But I cannot help it, you know. When I think of all the innocent people who've like been in, you know, similar situations as this, you know, over all this like decade, you know, and who've like had this done to them. I mean, this guy could have been executed. He could have gone to the electric chair or something, you know. It's just so sad, man. You know, a man that had so much ahead of him, right? And it was just taken away intentionally. I can understand if you make mistakes. You know, anybody can make a mistake. I can understand if they truly believed that he was, you know, he was the perpetrator. If they truly believed that he killed the man, I can understand that we made a mistake. But when you know for real that this man was innocent and you go to all that extent to do that to him, right? It's like, for me, guys like that should burn, you know. But I don't know. It's just terrible. And it's a shame, like I said to you, that the music is so good, you know. I've had quite a few Dylan songs now. And for me, this is the grooviest one, man. You know, it's just like beautiful music, man. And I just kept thinking to myself, why does it have to be, you know, to such a sad... Or, okay, maybe sad, that's cool. But to this particular thing, because I felt guilty trying to enjoy it because I'm saying to myself, Harry, this is somebody's life, man. You know, don't start, you know, grooving to the song, you know. But I think the reason why he made, you know, the backing track like this is what I said earlier. That's my thought. I thought he wanted to appeal, you know, to the black people as well. So he did something that was more like R&B, that was like groovy. That's what I think. I could be wrong. Maybe it was a subconscious thing. I don't know. But for me, one of his best works, you know, the storytelling, you know, the phrasing, the music, you know, the sentiments behind it, you know, it's just like a beautiful song, man. This is just wonderful, you know. I cannot fault this song in any way at all, you know. I'm not going to say any more because I might just get in trouble. I hope you enjoyed your stay here. If it was your first time, thank you for stopping by. Hope you come back again. I hope you subscribe and become a part of the family. And I promise next time I wouldn't be so emotional. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a big like for me, guys, so that the YouTube people can put it towards more people. Maybe more people will get to hear the story as well. Thank you for stopping by. Wherever you are, stay safe and stay good. But most of all, stay beautiful in your heart and soul. And I'll see you all next up. Bye-bye.